Hello and welcome to a video lecture in Sociology. Today we are going to discuss Chapter 6 titled as Globalization and Social Change from your textbook Social Change and Development in India. This chapter is divided into four parts. The first part deals with understanding the concept of globalization or what do we mean by globalization. In the second part, we'll raise some important questions such as, is globalization a new phenomena? In the third part of the chapter, we'll talk about the various aspects or dimensions about globalization, such as economic, political, and social. And in the fourth part, we'll discuss about globalization and broad cultural changes. No discussion on social change in the 21st century can take place without referring to the process of globalization. You might have heard about the concept in different areas and in different ways. Other than your school books, you must have come across the term globalization in newspapers, television programs, or even in everyday discussions. But what do we mean by globalization? Or what is global? Let us try to understand or make sense of this concept first. As you know, the modern period from about 18th century till the present time has seen the extraordinary pace of development and processes of social change. The changes that have happened in only last 200 years are more profound than changes that have happened throughout the human history. No single factor or theory or dimension can explain all these changes in totality or completely. These changes are a consequence of a complex matrix of different social, political, economic, cultural, environmental, and physical factors. And these influences are quite unique in nature. Among the factors bringing about modernity and social change, the important ones are industrial revolution, the rise of industrial capitalism, rise of modern democratic form of political organization, lately the emergence of science, technology, rationality and critical modes of thinking, which were a consequence of the process of enlightenment in European societies. As we have discussed in other chapters, that the discipline of sociology developed as a way of understanding and studying dramatic changes in social life. The most significant process of social change recently experienced and which is happening now is globalization. In fact, globalization is one of the most contemporary, widely discussed and most controversial areas of study for sociologists. But why is it so? This is because the concept of globalization is contested in nature. What do we mean by contested? By contested, we mean that there is no single definition of the phenomena or process of globalization. Different disciplines and scholars define it in different ways. Different subjects or academic disciplines focus on different aspects of globalization. Say, economists deal more with economic dimensions, such as flow of capital. The political scientist may focus more on the political dimensions. However, the very process of globalization is so far-reaching that various disciplines have to increasingly refer to each other to understand both the causes and consequences and various dimensions of globalization. Let us see how sociology seeks to understand globalization. Simply stating, globalization is a process of social change. Social change in broad terms means transformation in the nature and structure of society, including economy, polity, and culture. Social change entails an alteration or transformation in the structure, customs, institutions, and culture of society brought about or initiated by various factors. Sociologists use the concept of globalization to explore the contemporary changes taking place at the global level. Let us elaborate this point. We have already discussed earlier the scope of sociology and distinctive character of sociological perspective. The scope of sociological study is extremely wide. If on one hand it can focus on micro-level interactions between individuals, such as that between a shopkeeper and a customer, between a teacher and a student, between friends, peer group or family members. Similarly, it can also focus on macro-level phenomena and processes such as national issues, issues regarding unemployment, caste conflict or religious conflicts, or even the effect of state policies on rights of the tribal population, rural indebtedness or suicide by farmers. So, sociology also examines global social processes such as the impact of flexible labor regulations on the working class, or that of the electronic media on the youth, or the entry of foreign universities on the education system of the country. So, what defines the discipline of sociology is not just what it studies, that is the various social institutions, but also how it studies a chosen field, that is what do we mean by or how we explore a given area that is under study. Thus, sociology goes beyond everyday life. It is a debunking science. It attempts to understand issues in terms of its causes and consequences. Talking about globalization particularly, sociology studies how global developments are affecting the lives of ordinary people and the wide-ranging and different kind of changes that globalization is bringing about in our society. Since sociology is not defined by what it studies, but also how it studies, it would not be right to say that sociology only studies the social or cultural consequences of globalization. Sociologists use the sociological imagination to make sense of connections between the individual and the society, the micro and the macro, the local and the global, as the interconnectedness of different people, cultures, issues and problems continue to increase across globe. It poses certain questions like, how is a peasant affected in a remote village by globalization? How is he connected to global economic changes? So, sociologists study any process in totality. Talking particularly about globalization, sociologists may ask n number of questions, such as, how globalization has affected the chances of employment for the middle class? How globalization has affected the possibilities of big Indian corporations becoming transnational corporations? What does it mean to a small grocery shop owner if the retail sector is thrown open to big transnational companies? Why are there so many shopping malls in our cities and towns today? How this change has occurred over a period of time? We may ask an important question that how has it changed the way young people spend their leisure time? In general, any kind of social change or whatever kind of cultural change is coming about, how these changes are being influenced by forces of globalization. In the context of some of these questions that we have raised, let us try to comprehend meaning of globalization, or how do we define globalization. You can see that we have come across the term in many ways. Malcolm Waters defines globalization a social process in which constraints of geography on economic, political, social and cultural arrangements recede, in which people become increasingly aware that they are receding. In fact, there is no single definition of concept of globalization. Different disciplines and sociologists particularly approach the study of globalization differently depending upon the fact that what they believe to exist. You may ask questions regarding globalization such as, is it an economic, social or cultural phenomena? Is globalization a new phenomena or a continuation of existing processes of social change? Is globalization complete? Is globalization inevitable or is globalization irreversible or reversible? No aspect in contemporary life has remained unaffected by the process of globalization. It has influenced practically all the aspects of present day life, like trade, integration of economies, capitalism, brands, outsourcing, consumer products, information technology, environment and communication. Think of an area and you will find forces of globalization have directly or indirectly influenced it. Globalization has also affected our lives at the micro level, like our family structure, work culture, religious practices, beliefs, lifestyles, education patterns, leisure activities, media, culture and society. Simply stating, globalization is characterized by deepening and widening of the interconnectedness and interdependence between various institutions and systems in the world. Interconnectedness of economy or interdependence of various countries over one another for various things. Globalization can also be stated as an intensification of various kind of relationship between different societies. As convergence theories had put forward, that ultimately the world will converge towards a kind of global homogeneous culture. Globalization, in fact, is seen by some that it is leading to convergence and emergence of homogeneous culture. Globalization is also leading to expanding and stretching of relationships. This can also be seen as deterritorialization of various kinds of things, where economy is no longer confined to a particular territory or a nation state. Globalization is also about emergence of global consciousness and awareness of the world as a whole. What do we mean by global consciousness or awareness of the world as a whole? You might have come across various examples that environmentalism or environmental issues have become a global concern, which means that people are increasingly realizing that nothing is, restricted to the boundaries of a particular nation, and they are conscious about the fact what is happening in the other part of the world. Let us look at some of the examples to see how globalization is affecting our lives. You are part of a social networking site, making friends throughout the world using internet. Not only friends, you can also become part of social movements and protests concerning global and national issues. You can also express your thoughts to people all over the world using these social networking sites. You can work for or buy a product from a company operating transnationally. You can trade, invest money, or carry out banking with a multinational bank or in a bank located in a different continent. You can also enjoy food, chocolates, and drink and consume products from different parts of the world, which are now available locally because of intensification of relationship or economic relationship between national economies. People can enjoy music, watch films, or keep a track of news and events happening in any part of the world round the clock. What do these examples indicate? These examples indicate that globalization is bringing rapid and important changes in social life, and it is affecting almost every aspect of our daily life. Taking into account the case of Indian society, you know that with the opening up of market and removal of restrictions to the import of many products, we have now seen many more products from different corners of the world in our neighborhood shops. With liberalization and privatization in the last two decades, a whole new range of products found entry in the Indian market. Our lifestyles have changed. There is a wide variety available for us to consume now. But the same set of policy changes affects consumers and producers differently. What may mean a greater choice for the urban affluent consumer may mean a crisis of livelihood for a poor shopkeeper or a marginal farmer. These changes are personal because they affect individuals' lives and lifestyles. But they indicate close interrelation between your personal lives and processes of globalization. As mentioned earlier, the sociological imagination enables to make this connection between the micro and the macro, between the personal and the public. For instance, a sociologist cannot study society as an isolated entity disconnected from the wider world. A study of a village not only meant study of different social groups and their societies, but also takes into account the ways the village society was linked or connected to the outside world. This linkage is more valid today than ever before. The compression of time and space has changed the structure of society. Whatever contemporary sociology studies like villages, families, social movements, work and leisure, bureaucratic organizations, or caste system, it takes processes of global or globalization into account. One such instance of interconnections can be seen in the case of families of the people who have migrated to other countries. These migrants serve as economic, social, and cultural link between the home country and the country of destination. They regularly send money back home to their families, which is called as remittance. Apart from money, these immigrants have created linkages. These linkages lead to change in pattern of consumption and lifestyle of these people. Wherever migrants or diaspora communities are settled, they establish cultural contacts with their families back home, influencing their culture and structure in the society in many ways. These interactions are going to grow in number and intensity because of the means of rapid transportation and communication available to us now. Imagine how long people used to wait for a message like a letter to reach before the means of telecommunications were fully developed and came within the reach of common people. The effects of process of globalization are far-reaching. They affect us all, but differently. While for some globalization may mean the loss of livelihood, for others it means new opportunities opening up for them. So to conclude, let's summarize what we discussed in this lecture. We started our discussion with the concept of globalization and discussed features of globalization. Subsequently, we discussed why globalization is a contested phenomena or a contested concept. We also discussed about various spheres, sectors, and manner in which globalization has influenced our lives. In the next part of this lecture, we'll discuss about some features of globalization in greater detail. Till then, you can enjoy reading this part of the chapter. Thank you.